Joining us now is Republican Congressman Adam Kinzinger. He serves on the Foreign Affairs Committee. He is also a member of the Air National Guard, and he served in Iraq and Afghanistan with the Air Force. Congressman, good morning.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing well. So what are your questions today about what went wrong in Niger?
We want to know the details of what happened. I think that's going to be information that comes out. The military is being very smart to say, let's get all the information before the report comes out. What I think we have to be careful of, as a military guy, I can say this too, we like to jump to conclusions sometimes. We like to say, well, why weren't there fighter jets supporting Green Berets? Why didn't we have M1 Abrams tanks and Humvees and all this? What people need to understand is special forces, specifically Green Berets, the reason they're so good at what they do, the reason they have so much training, is because their job is to go into a place unsupported and to help native troops of that country be a strong partner in terms of fighting Al-Qaeda, or they've done this in South America in terms of fighting drug lords and everything else. They are specifically used in tough areas, unsupported, to do this good work. So I think while we do need answers, that's 100% sure. We need to quickly understand, though, that this is their job, is to do very difficult things, and it's unfortunate we think about them when something like this happens.
Congressman, I want to play for you what President Trump said yesterday about this mission and whether or not he authorized it. So listen to this.
It's a dangerous business, I have to say. It's a dangerous business. So what? No, I didn't. Not specifically. But I have generals that are great generals. These are great fighters. These are warriors.
And
I gave them authority to do what's right so that we win. That's the authority they have. I want to win.
So I'm interested in your take on this, Congressman, because President Trump has said all along he wants the generals to have more autonomy. He doesn't want them to feel hamstrung by the chain of command, having to wait for permission for things. But should the commander-in-chief take responsibility for missions like this?
Well, I think it's one thing to say, you know, kind of the buck stops here from that perspective. So, yes, ultimately every decision really rests with the president. I think the president, though, was technically correct in saying he didn't authorize this mission. Not that he didn't want the mission to go on, not that he was passing blame to other generals. But look, if a president has to authorize every mission in the microcosm by every military unit everywhere in the world, he'd never be able to do anything else and would frankly never get around to authorizing all the missions that he'd authorize. This war on terror is worldwide. I've actually argued that this is, in essence, a low-grade World War III. It's happening everywhere. And frankly, that's what happens when you have a group and a cancer like ISIS or Al-Qaeda. And so while that's technically correct, yes, there's maybe an inarticulate way of saying it, like, yeah, ultimately everything rests with me on that responsibility. But frankly, and as a military guy, look, when you have decisions closer to the battlefield, so basically the lower they have to crawl up the chain of command, the actually more effective those decisions are and the more timely they are.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's move on to a different topic, and that is Russia sanctions. As you well know, Congress passed legislation about this. The president signed it somewhat begrudgingly, it was reported, but they haven't happened. The deadline for these to go into effect were October 1st. It's now the 26th. So what's the holdup?
So this is, over the last couple days, something I found out wasn't happening. I always just assumed it was going to. So this is kind of like breaking news to me a little bit. We're going to do a lot of inquiring into this. I think a lot of folks are. This will get done. I think there should be absolutely no doubt when the will of Congress, the House and the Senate, says we must sanction Russia for their involvement in attempting to change our election or influence our election of us and any other Western countries. This must get done, and there should be no doubt in the administration that will compel this. We don't know the details. Maybe there's a technical reason, but look, this will get done. Have no doubt.
Is it up to the White House to implement it?
Yeah, and you know, look, I mean, when you pass something, it may take time for that to happen. Maybe our deadline was too short. I don't know the answers. I'm just going to be very clear. This will happen. You cannot violate the will of the House and the Senate. This will happen.
Very quickly, Republican unity on a scale of 1 to 10. What do you rate it?
Oh, it's a 10. I mean, it's just wonderful. Now, look, we're having this like open food fight right now on the national and the world stage. It's pretty embarrassing if you're a Republican to watch this stuff happen. But it's not, you know, going to change my mission out here, which is to make America an example of self-governance to billions of people and to continue to try to make us stronger domestically. But it's not fun to wake up every morning and see a new, you know, little spat going on in our party.
Well, you know, with a food fight, just duck. That's the general advice.
That's
Congressman Adam Kinzinger, thank you very much.
You